Got strength that they can't quite understand. In a real sense, we got to beat the odds, but we've also got to change the odds. And when we do that, we recognize it's never either or. It's both and. It's not charity or justice. It's charity and justice. It's not self-help or fighting the system. It's self-help and fighting the system. We have a responsibility to do both and. Why? Because the hood, please don't miss this, in a real sense, systematically and structurally, is diabolically designed to the disadvantage of the disinherited. And that is why, my brothers and sisters, when we meet heaven's hero and earth's emancipator in our passage, I'm blown away, because Jesus, watch this, starts his ministry not in the big city of Jerusalem, not in the religious capital, not in the academic capital of Athens, nor the political capital of Rome, but the text says he begins in Galilee. He's on the outskirts, and then he comes home where he had been raised, in Nazareth. And anybody who knows about Nazareth, you know that Nazareth was the hood. It was the hood. Wasn't anything good supposed to come out of the hood? That's why when someone heard that the Messiah had come from Nazareth, their response was, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? And yet here we see a rose coming out of the concrete of the hood in Nazareth. And Jesus, I love it, comes home to the hood in the power of the Spirit, and on the Lord's day, as was his custom, he found himself in worship at the Lord's house. I like that. He had a holy habit on the Lord's day of going to the Lord's house on the Lord's day. I kind of feel that right there. The Lord's day in the Lord's house to give worship to the Lord above us. We're talking about the Son of God who made it a holy habit to worship God on the day of worship. Y'all missed your shout right there. After all, what else ought you do on the Lord's day but give God worship and praise? After all, when you come to worship, you recognize that you are ascribing worth to God. That's what worship is. Worship etymologically, it means to ascribe worth to. When you worship, you're saying, God, this is how much you are worth in my life. That means I worship God regardless of who's preaching or who's singing, because it's really about the worth I'm ascribing to the God above me. I worship God because I know what God has done for me. Of course, the Greek word for worship, proskuneo, it means to kiss the hand of God. And whenever you are kissing the hand, I guess I got to give it to you like this. It's a word picture of a lap dog that is licking the hand of its owner. Why would a lap dog do that? A lap dog does that. Why? Because it's those hands that feed that dog. It's those hands that pick up that dog. It's those hands that protect and take care of that dog. I got to let the dog out of me right quick, because there's somebody in here who can testify. When I come to church on Sunday, I'm trying to get at the hand of God, because I know what God's hand has done for me. God's hands have taken care of me. God's hands have picked me up. God's hands have carried me. God's hands have protected me. And so he's worshiping the Lord on the Lord's day, and his name is Jesus. And the Bible says Jesus has that holy habit goes in the synagogue to worship, and then they bring him the scroll and allow him to be the guest preacher that day. And Jesus finds his place, and look at the place he found. The place he found was Isaiah 61, and there, beginning in verse 1, Jesus reads these words: "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because God has anointed me to preach good news to the poor, to set the captives free, to heal those who are broken, to proclaim the acceptable year of Jubilee," or the year of economic justice. Y'all missed every shout I just gave you. Here is Jesus in all of his power. Jesus, like a rose out of concrete, a lily rising above the swamp, has been able to blossom anyhow. He's got power when he comes to the hood. But look at him as he testifies, "I'm not here simply satisfied that I rose above my circumstance. I'm here to change the circumstances so the poor experience good news, the captives are set free, and the blind receive their sight." Y'all still not getting this thing. I'm here not just to beat the odds. I'm here to change the odds, because I'm here to bring about justice.
Frederick West Baptist Church.